Our next film is an important new American movie called Silkwood, starring Meryl Streep as the late Karen Silkwood, who in 1974 became a martyr for the anti-nuclear power movement when she died suspiciously as she was about to blow the whistle to a New York Times reporter about unsafe working conditions involving the handling of plutonium at her plant in Oklahoma. In this scene, Karen is trying to steal documents from her supervisor's desk, showing that the company she works for has been altering x-rays to make their fuel rods seem stronger than they really are.
What are you doing in there? What are you doing in my desk?
If I tell you, you promise not to tell anybody? I keep my pills in there, in that drawer, because I have an allergy, and they don't let you bring medication into the plant, so I hid them in there.
I don't believe you.
Well, I think you should take a person's word for something.
These don't look like antihistamines to me.
Winston, these are little tiny time capsules. Like the ones you see on TV.
That's a very scary moment in this movie because the film goes on to suggest that someone at the company then plotted to poison Karen with plutonium. But in addition to revealing Karen's perilous life at work, the movie also spends at least half of its time with Karen at home, living in a shack with an auto mechanic boyfriend, Kurt Russell, and a lesbian co-worker played by Cher. She and Cher's character get into a fight after both of their lovers have left them.
Let me tell you something, girl. Drew left on account of you. On account of you and Angela.
Well, if you believe that, you're even crazier than people say. You took about as good care of Drew as you took of your kids. I know that you took good care of your kids.
You know, the only thing everybody says I'm crazy about is to live with you.
Now, what I really appreciate about this movie is scenes like that, not its nuclear power issues, but the way this fine film reminds us of who does the real work in America and under what conditions. This film reminded me of how infrequently American movies deal honestly with the working class. Silkwood does that, and it does it quite well. This is not just a movie, then, about one big dramatic death. It's about workers dying lots of little deaths every single day on the job. It's a fine film.
I agree with you. I think it's a really good film. One of the things that surprised me about it pleasantly was that it's not a conspiracy film. And this film was originally announced 3, 4, 5 years ago as a project. At one point, Jane Fonda was going to star in it. Various other people were interested. And I think it was seen then as an expose about the evil people who run the nuclear factory and how they killed Karen Silkwood.
China Syndrome Part 2.
Exactly. Right. In this film, it's left ambiguous as to exactly how Karen Silkwood died or if anybody killed her. It's left up in the air because it's really a portrait of these people, of the way they work, of the conditions, of the way the union in Washington really doesn't really care about them, and how the workers are more concerned with keeping their jobs than with plutonium or anything else, and about how Karen Silkwood gets involved in this process almost against her own will. It's really fascinating at that level. It's so much more interesting than if it were a conspiracy movie.
Yes, and it reminded me of another film that Meryl Streep made, The Deer Hunter, where she played this worker in a one-factory town again. And that film showed who fought the war in Vietnam. It showed who left one hell at work to go fight a war. This film was, again, about just the grind, the grinding down of the spirit at work. And we just, that whole class of people is ignored in Hollywood movies, and I appreciated seeing that.
I like, and I also love the performances. Kurt Russell, from all the Disney pictures, and Cher, from Sonny and Cher, you wouldn't think could play absolutely authentic, convincing, three-dimensional lovable, heartbreaking characters, and they do. We expect a great performance from Streep, and we get one, but these other two are surprisingly good.
Yeah, they're not Hollywood stars condescending to a working-class role. They're authentic.
That's right. One more thumbs up for Silkwood with Meryl Streep as an angry nuclear worker. We split on the one that Silkwood. Is an obvious choice is Silkwood, which I think is a real terrific movie.
I think people are thinking it's maybe too downbeat for them. I found it curiously up in the sense that I was startled by its portrait of the working class, and I was not walking out of the theater holding my head in my hands.
Mm-hmm. Okay.